Hi students, so as I told in the last video, so in this video part number 7, so let us go through some numerical problems, okay? So first you note down the problem number 1, very simple problem. Let us start with the simple problem. With what minimum acceleration can a fireman slide down a rope where breaking strength is 2/3 of his weight? Okay, so can you just follow this problem? So with what minimum acceleration, you have to find the minimum acceleration for a fireman who is sliding down. Just look at the diagram. See, this is the rope actually. So over the rope, a fireman is sliding down. Okay, a fireman is sliding down. Okay, with what minimum acceleration you have to find. So because whenever he is moving, he is accelerated, isn't it? So with what minimum acceleration he can slide down over the rope so that it should not break. Okay, the rope should not cut down. So that is the condition here. With what minimum acceleration can a fireman slide down a rope where breaking strength is 2/3 of his weight? Breaking strength of the rope, you have to understand here. Okay, breaking strength of the rope should be, okay, 2/3 of his weight. In that particular condition, what is the minimum acceleration? Okay, if you cross that acceleration, then the rope may cut down. Okay, that should not happen. So within that minimum acceleration, the fireman has to slide down. So that is the simple problem here. Okay, now let us consider. See, with respect to this diagram, again you can understand that, so when the fireman is sliding down, okay, so what is his weight? He is actually sliding down with his weight. So you have to consider m into g, where m is the mass of the fireman and g is the acceleration due to gravity. Okay, when he is sliding down over the rope, what is the opposing force, you can say? So the rope is consisting of another force in the opposite direction, that is called tension, right? So it is in the opposite direction. So we can write, if m is the mass of the fireman, okay, and t is the tension in the rope, then very simply we can write down that net downward force will be equal to just mg minus t. Mg is the downward force, opposite by tension, so minus t. Okay, and if the fireman is accelerated with a, then if a is the acceleration, you can write the movement of the fireman according to Newton's second law is given by force acting on the fireman is given by m into a, isn't it? So that m into a is equal to mg minus t. Okay, so with this force the fireman is sliding down here. Okay, now this is very important equation for you. Ma is equal to mg minus t. Okay, now let us consider the given condition. If t maximum, that means the maximum tension in the rope, is equal to, as given, 2/3 of his weight. So you have to write it as 2/3 of his weight, means m into g only, right? M into g. So 2/3 of m into g. So with that condition, you have to assume that the acceleration should be minimum. So a is equal to a minimum. Okay, now substitute that m into a minimum in this, in the equation 1, m into a minimum is equal to mg, okay, minus t. What is t at that condition? T is equal to 2/3 of mg. Okay, that's it. Now it is a simplification only, the part. So take the LCM, 3mg minus 2mg divided by 3. Okay, 3mg minus 2mg is equal to mg divided by 3. Okay, so what we want here, the only acceleration, a minimum, is equal to, so by cancelling m on both sides, you will get a minimum is equal to 1/3 of g. Okay, 1/3 of the acceleration due to gravity. So within that acceleration, the fireman has to slide down, okay, where the breaking strength of the rope is equal to 2/3 of his weight. Clear? Okay, now let us see the next problem. So a man weighs 70 kg, he stands on weighing scale. Okay, just note down this problem also. A man weighs 70 kg, he stands on a weighing scale, that means it is like a machine, weighing machine, in a lift. So you have to note that, where is that weighing machine? It is inside the lift. Okay, you know, lift is used to go up and down in the multi-story buildings, right? So a man is now standing on a weighing scale in the lift, which is moving. The lift is moving. How it is moving? So upwards with a uniform speed of 10 meter per second. So it is moving with the speed of 10 meter per second. So that is actually the constant speed you have to assume, because it is uniform speed. Then downwards also, it may move in the downwards with a uniform acceleration of 5 meter per second square. Okay. And then again it upwards, it moves in the upwards with a uniform acceleration of again 5 meter per second square. So like that the lift is moving up and down. Okay. Is it clear? So in the first case, upwards with a uniform speed with 10 meter per second square, downward with a uniform acceleration 5 meter per second square, upward with a uniform acceleration 5 meter per second square again. Okay. Now in this example, what would be the reading of the scale? Okay, because the man is standing on the weighing machine, so the scale is showing his weight. Okay, so what would be the reading of the scale in each case? In each case A, B, C, you have to find his weight read by the weighing machine. And also, what would be the reading if the lift mechanism failed and it hurtled down freely under gravity? Suppose if the lift mechanism is failed and the lift is falling down freely, okay, then what would be the reading of the scale? So this is the problem for you. Okay, very simple it is actually. You have to understand only thing, how the velocity and acceleration are changes in each case. That's it. So we need the equations to find that reading, equation for the reading on the scale. So the reading on the scale is nothing but what actually? It is the weight of the man. That's it. Okay. So what is the given data for that? So consider first, M is equal to 70 kg. In terms of kg, they are given. A man weighs 70 kg. Okay. Then velocity, uniform velocity is 10 meter per second. And when it is moving up and down with a uniform acceleration, in both the cases it is given as 5 meter per second square. Okay. Now let us see the solution part. When the lift is at rest, what you will understand? When the lift is at rest, and similarly when it moves with uniform velocity, maybe up or down. Okay. So you have to assume that in this case acceleration is always zero, whether it is rest or it is moving with uniform velocity up or down. You have to assume that acceleration is zero. Clear? Okay. Next, what is the apparent weight? So apparent weight is just nothing but the reading on the scale, or let it be R is the reading on the scale. So R is equal to M into G. So due to its weight, so you have to consider M into G, weight of the man read by the scale, equation 1. Now let us consider the lift is moving. So if the lift accelerated upwards, in this case when the lift is accelerated upwards, then what is the net force? Equation for net force, according to Newton's second law, again M into A, because it is accelerated, A is acceleration here, M into A is equal to R minus mg, you have to consider, isn't it? Because R is actually is downward motion. Okay, so I mean is weight in the downward direction, so it is opposite by mg. So R minus mg you have to consider when it is accelerated in the upward direction. Okay, so therefore you can consider now R is equal to mg plus ma. So you take R at one side and minus mg is there, now you take it in the left hand side, you will get mg plus ma. So m is common, so that m into g plus a you will get, isn't it? So reading on the scale is equal, now equation is m into g plus a. Clear? Similarly, I will consider when the lift accelerate downwards, what is the equation? When it is accelerated downwards. Okay. So now in this case mg must be greater, because moving in the same direction of mg, so mg must be greater. So therefore R is equal to, now instead of ma minus mg, okay, you have to take mg minus ma. Okay, in this case of course it is R minus mg, here it is mg is greater, so mg minus ma you have to consider, because it is accelerated downwards. Okay, so m is common again into g minus a. Inside the bracket you'll get g minus a. Let it be equation 3. Like that you'll get 3 equations first. Okay, if you understand the problem, you will get these 3 equations easily. First is apparent weight, as it is given by R is equal to mg, even when the lift is at rest. Okay, when the lift is accelerated upwards, weight of the man or reading on the scale, both are same here, is given by R is equal to m into g plus a from equation 2. When the lift is accelerated downwards, then R is equal to m into g minus a as per equation 3. Okay, now consider for the calculation. In the first case, upward motion, you have to consider the upward motion with uniform speed they are given, isn't it? So first case is upward motion with uniform speed. When the lift is moving with uniform speed, what is the acceleration? A is equal to 0, right? Acceleration is 0 for uniform speed. Okay, now consider just the first equation. When acceleration is 0, we can directly use this first equation to calculate the reading on the scale. So that is given by m into g. So m is already given, 70 kg, and g is equal to 9.8. okay, multiply, you will get 686 newton. Okay, 686 newton is the reading on the scale. Next, second part they asked here is downward motion. Okay, downward motion with a is equal to how much? Given 5 meter per second square. Okay, now you have to substitute a value. Okay, which is the equation you have to use? So downward motion means here it is. Okay, accelerates downwards. So what is the equation? R m into g minus a. So that is the equation used here. R is equal to m into g minus a. Just substitute all the values. M is equal to 70 kg, g is equal to 9.8, and a is given as 5 meter per second square. So 9.8 minus 5 and then into 70 will give you the answer 336 newton. Okay, so like that the reading decreases here. Okay, next, again in the case C, you have to consider upward motion with uniform acceleration. So write down that C here. So upward motion with acceleration is how much? A is equal to 5 meter per second square. Okay, so for upward motion, which is the equation you have to use? Equation 2, I think, right? Here it is. R is equal to m into g plus a. Okay, so m into g plus a, substitute the value of m, g, and a is again 5. But now the reading increases. So when the lift is moving in the upward motion, moving in the upward direction, okay, the reading of the scale increases. The weight of the man is increased. So that is equal to how much? Calculated value 1036 newton. Okay, like that the weight of the man is increasing or decreasing, okay, depending upon how the lift is moving up and down here. Okay, so these are the cases A, B, C, calculated values as per the problem. So one more thing is asked here. You look at here, what would be the reading if the lift mechanism failed? If the lift mechanism failed, nothing but what? The ropes are broken or something is happened. Okay, then immediately the lift is just falling down freely under gravity. Okay, so when the lift is falling under gravity, you look at here. When the lift falls freely, when A is equal to G, you have to assume that moving with the acceleration due to gravity, isn't it? Acceleration is how much? A equal to G in that case. And then downward motion, which is the equation you have to use for downward motion? Here it is. Okay, so equation 3, downward motion. So R is equal to m into g minus a, right? R is equal to m into g minus a. So here you substitute. Now a is equal to again g. So m into g minus g, g minus g is 0. So you will get R is equal to 0 newton. So what do you mean by that? Reading on the scale is 0 newton means the weight of the man is 0, weightless. Okay, the body becomes weightless when the lift is falls freely without any forces acting on it. Okay, so 0 newton is the answer. Okay, now go through the next problem. two masses, 7 kg and 12 kg are connected at the two ends of a light inextensible string. Okay. So that goes over a frictionless pulley. Find the acceleration of the masses and the tension in the string when the masses are released. So it is just a simple experiment. You just look at this diagram, you will understand the problem. See, there are two masses M1 and M2, okay, fixed to the two ends of a inextensible string, and then it is just passing over a pulley. Okay, so the moment you leave the masses, okay, the masses will move up and down depending upon the mass. Okay, now here the given masses are 7 kg and 12 kg. If I assume that M1 is equal to 7 kg and M2 is equal to 12 kg, okay, let us say this is M2. Automatically, you can expect that the system is moving in such a way that M2 is going down, M1 is moving in upward direction, right? Okay, like this, right? So motion direction is like this now, the downward direction where M2 is connected. Okay, M1 is moving in the upward direction like this. Now for this system, you have to calculate. What you have to calculate here, you see, find the acceleration of the masses. Both the masses are moving the same acceleration. One is moving downwards, one is moving upward, that's it. But acceleration is same. Find that acceleration of the masses. Okay, and then tension in the string. Okay, either this side or this side, you can calculate the tension in the string also. Okay, now consider the given data. Masses M1 is equal to 7 kg, M2 is equal to 12 kg. And to find acceleration of the masses A and tension T, you just proceed by the assumption that force required to lift a mass M is equal to its weight. So here the concept is force must be equal to weight. How? The force required to lift any mass in the upward direction is equal to its weight only. In order to lift any weight, okay, so you have to apply certain force. What is that force required? That must be equal to its weight only, right? So with that concept, okay, M2 is actually the bigger mass here. So that is actually lifting the mass M1 in the upward direction, right? So M2 is equal to almost 12 kg, okay? So lifting the mass 7 kg in the upward direction. So part of its weight is used to lift the mass M1, okay? So you have to write down that M2 uses part of its weight to lift the mass M1, okay? The remaining force, so the remaining mass will be there, no? So that remaining force is used to produce acceleration in the system so that it is moving in the downward direction with the acceleration A, okay? So then what is the net force here? You have to calculate the net force, right? So net force is equal to, first you have to write this mass M2 into G, okay? M2 into G because moving in the downward direction, minus M1G, okay, part of its weight is used to lift the mass M1, I said. So M2G minus M1G you have to consider, okay? So that is actually the net force. So G is common, so write down G into M2 minus M1 as equation 1 here, right? Further, the same net force can also be written as total mass into acceleration, okay? Total mass into acceleration also. So therefore, you can cross multiply the equation to find acceleration, net force divided by total mass. Okay, net force is already calculated as G into M2 minus M1, substitute it here, G into M2 minus M1 divided by total mass is just M1 plus M2, that's it. Add the two masses, M1 plus M2, that gives total mass. Okay, then to calculate the acceleration of the two masses, just substitute all the given values here. 9.8 is the G value, M2 minus M1. 12 kg minus 7 kg divided by M1 plus M2, 7 plus 12, okay. So calculated acceleration is found to be 2.58 meter per second square. So next part is to find tension in the string. So look at the diagram again. As I said, I will consider the string either left side or right side. So I will consider now the two points A and B between the pulley and the mass M2. So between the points A and B, the string is under tension, okay? So consider the motion of the part AB, the string is, okay, go through the next problem. So this problem is similar to the previous problem. See, two masses are connected at the two ends of light inextensible string that passes over a frictionless pulley, correct? the difference in mass is given now. The difference in mass is how much? 0.5 kg. Okay, the system moves through 10 meter in 2 seconds. Okay, when the mass are moving up or down, so it is moving through 10 meter in 2 seconds. Starting from rest, so that means initial velocity is equal to 0. So what are the masses? What do you mean by that? So in the given data, difference in mass, if we consider as m2 minus m1 is equal to 0.5 kg given value, and the system is moving through the displacement 10 meter in 2 seconds, okay, we have to find the masses, individual masses, to find m1 is equal to how much, m2 is equal to how much. Like that, you have to find the individual masses. Okay, in the solution part, first you calculate the value of acceleration using the displacement formula. Okay, so one of the motion, equation of motion is S is equal to ut plus half at square. If you know the displacement and initial velocity and acceleration, you can calculate this S value or A value, whatever it is. Here in this case, initial velocity u is equal to 0. Starting from rest means what? U is equal to 0. Initial velocity is equal to 0. So this part will go. So that S is equal to half at square is the equation now. So cross multiply the equation, you will get A is equal to 2s by t square. Correct? Substitute the value of s and t. Okay. 10 meter in 2 seconds, 2 square is there. So you will get the value of acceleration as 5 meter per second square. Okay. Then our aim is to find the individual masses, you know. So once you know the acceleration, use the equation of acceleration of the system of two masses passing over the pulley. Okay, that is what actually we are given in the previous problem. Equation for the acceleration is A is equal to m1 minus m2 divided by m1 plus m2 into z. Correct? So this is the equation for the acceleration of a system of two masses passing over the pulley. Now, from equation 1, see, so look at the Omer problem for you now. Okay, so now here I mentioned a trolley of mass 1.5 kg is pulled along a table by a string attached to a mass of 0.02 kg hanging down over a pulley. If the trolley starts from rest, calculate the distance traveled by the body in 5 seconds. Okay, so in this problem, just look at the diagram. This is the trolley passing over the pulley of attached to a mass M. So take the trolley mass capital M and the mass attached is small m. So the given value is 1.5 and small m is 0.02 kg and it is passing over the pulley for the short interval of time t equal to 5 seconds, right? So use this equation A first, because it is already derived for the system of two masses passing over the pulley. So mg divided by m plus m, calculate this acceleration. So if you know the acceleration, you can calculate the s, because assuming initial velocity is equal to 0, okay, so this term will go, so that you can calculate s of at square. T is given, A is calculated here. Okay, so next you go through the problem 6. So in which the mass m splits into two parts, m1 and m2. So v1 is given, u is given, you have to find out the v2. Okay, using the law of conservation, you can find out that anyway. So see you in the next video.